Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified data management experts will reply in time. Business, technical, and IT departments often need to work together to process, analyze, or test important and complex data structures. But it's often too cumbersome and takes too long. SQACE is the low-code platform for IT and business that helps you to reduce complexity, achieve your goals faster, and fully realize your potential. Today, I will introduce this new data management tool. With this tool, business experts can directly implement analysis, data checks, data transformations, and much more themselves, all without a complex tool zoo, easily understandable together on one platform. IT and business experts can better fulfill even complex data missions, for example, data migrations or tests of data processing, or web services in a modern and agile working method, and faster than ever before. SQACE offers self-explanatory no-code components. With them, anyone can explore, check, and even perform very complex data queries themselves without SQL knowledge. Many standard tasks such as data comparison can be solved with SQACE components, and with just a few clicks, results are automatically saved and can be easily further used and shared with others. Even extensive workflows can be created via drag and drop, for example for automated data checking and data cleaning. In the other videos, I have already explained important SQACE standard functionalities. However, SQACE offers many more features. I can open the menu here once. I have already explained two actions, the comparison and easy query actions. In the quick selection, however, you will find other actions such as workflow and static data. Let me show you how to create a workflow. In step 1, I define compare 1 and compare 2, and in step 2, I define my easy update. The defined sequence is then executed. Of course, any other steps could follow here. So, you can simply call several actions at once, create an action sequence, or orchestrate what you want. Parameters can also be defined. For example, I can introduce a mission parameter deadline as a date. The default values are already set. Now I can pass the key date parameter to the actions. For example, I can now add my new key date parameter in compare 1 to filter by it. To do this, I go back to the workflow and select the key date here. The source is my action parameter key date. Now I can also pass the key date parameter to compare 1 so that everything can be parameterized and the filter can be changed dynamically depending on which key date I want to check. We can query data. I have already explained easy query. You can also use SQL or even implement rule-based mappers, which I will present in another video. It is possible to define mapping rules, which make it easy to implement case distinctions. For example, I would like to pass on a value according to defined rules. However, if the value B is equal to Z, then please pass on a different value, otherwise output 0. We can therefore define a set of rules, which is also an element in the mission. There is also a mission equipment object, which I will discuss separately in another video, as it is a big topic. SQACE can read data from all data formats such as CSV, XML, JSON, fixed length, and Excel. Of course, SQL databases are also supported as already mentioned. Data can be changed by inserting, updating, and deleting via low-code as well as in SQL. We can also check data using various test procedures. We can use information such as value ranges, numbers of rows, and uniqueness, or also check statements and identification keys. In this way, very powerful data quality checks can be put together by simply using these different elements and then assembling them in the workflow. There are two basic approaches when it comes to transactions. Firstly, the classic commit process. Secondly, execute with subsequent commit. With one of the approaches, you first have a preview of the data changes. Only when you are certain can you apply these changes permanently. This is where the concept of transactional working comes into play. Transactions allow you to initially only make changes virtually. These changes are therefore not final until you execute a commit. If something goes wrong, you can undo everything at any time with a rollback. This allows you to work securely and flexibly with your data. Now let's move on to importing data. An example, when importing a file, for example, customer exported.csv, the file name is often adopted automatically. This can be problematic if the file is not named. This is the import of a so-called customer CSV. The correct column assignment is particularly important when importing. The default assignment is by position. This means that the column in the third position of the source file is read into the third position column of the database, regardless of its name. However, if the order in the source file is changed, for example, if first name and last name are swapped, this can lead to incorrect results. A better alternative is the assignment by column name. Here, you can activate additional options to correct possible deviations. Ignore upper and lower case. Remove spaces at the beginning and end. And hide special characters or line breaks. These settings can also be used to correctly assign differently named columns in the header of the CSV file. Even if first name and last name are swapped or formatted differently, every value ends up in the correct column. To summarize, transactions and flexible column assignments make working with databases efficient and secure. Use these functions to manage your data precisely and avoid errors. I will now show you how deviations in the table structure can be handled and tested. We will look at various scenarios, such as missing columns, unexpected columns, or columns in a different position. Let's assume that an expected column, such as last name, is no longer delivered. The system automatically recognizes that this column is missing. In such cases, we can configure that a warning is logged. A test case can also be created. This test case checks whether the column is present. If the column is there, the test case is marked as pass. If it is missing, it is displayed as failed. Another scenario. An additional unexpected column suddenly appears in a new file. Here too, we can log a warning and create a test case. The test case documents whether there are any unexpected columns. In this way, deviations in the structure can be systematically identified. What happens if a column changes its position within the table? There are solutions for this too. We can simply use the column without logging into a warning. In addition, we can have a test case created that checks whether the column is in the correct position. If it is in the expected position, the test case is pass. Otherwise, it will be marked as failed. Let's see the whole thing in action. The CSV reader can be run to analyze the data. The result is displayed in the Result tab. If no deviations are found, the Errors tab remains empty. In the Test Results tab, we can see the test cases created. One example is the Different Header test case, which is divided into subcategories such as Missing Column. These show exactly which columns are missing or have been changed. To summarize, with these configurations, you can precisely detect deviations in the table structure, log warnings, and create test cases. Try it out and optimize your data processing. Now let's take a look at how our system checks unexpected columns and their order, as well as what other tests can be performed to ensure data quality. Let's start with the so-called unexpected columns and the unexpected column order. We have selected three columns to be included in the test. These were successfully tested, all passed. But what happens if the order is not correct? The severity is defined here as significant. This means that if a column appears in a different position, this is marked as an error, a failed. This ensures that the structure of your data always remains consistent. Our system goes even further. Each column is also checked for its format. You can make individual settings for this, such as ignore data conversion errors, log warnings, or cancel processing in the event of errors. An example, the column create date. If the expected format is year-month-date and a different format is found, this leads to an error. The test check all values in column create date are valid and would then fail. Another highlight is the complete overview of the workflow. For example, if you import and compare 20 files, our system creates a complete overview of all tests at the end. Here, you can see at a glance which tests were successful and where errors occurred. This overview gives you control over your data. SQACE not only checks columns and their sequence, but also ensures that the data formats are correct. The complete overview always gives you a full overview of your test cases. SQACE offers professional SQL and multi-environment support and is easy to integrate with other systems, for example with test management systems or CI/CD pipelines. This case makes the reuse of components simple and promotes collaborative work across team boundaries. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our SQACE-certified data management experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about data management and software quality. Happy data management and testing. See you next time.